take me out to the ball game.
Go!
Take me out to the ball
game. Go, 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 go!
Come on, Jake, go first! Go!
Buy me some peanuts.
Jake!
And Cracker Jack.
Go! Go!
My name is Jake Nordstrom, and I've done a report on the book You Can Teach Hitting by Dusty Baker. As you may know, Dusty Baker is the best manager of the major leagues. He's managed the San Francisco Giants, the Chicago Cubs, and now the Cincinnati Reds. I've known Dusty since I was about 2 years old, and I've visited him several times over the years. My grandpa's really close friends with him. I'm 11 years old, and over the summer, when I went to his house, his son Darren and I took some batting practice in their batting cage. After seeing what I had done in the cage, Dusty gave me the book You Can Teach Hitting to read. I didn't read the book over the summer, but when the independent reading project was assigned to me, I took the opportunity to do something that I've always wanted to do and chose making an iMovie as my product. I chose to make a short video with some of the most important drills and suggestions I learned in this book. After weeks and weeks of editing and filming, this is what I came out with. Hope you enjoy. So basically where I like to line up when I come up to the plate, usually on the first couple of pitches, I'll line up my foot parallel with the beginning of the plate right here. And so I can adjust to it as I adapt to the pitcher. Like if he's slow, I'll go up. If he's fast, I'll go back. But usually I'll go right about here. So what I like to do, just because it feels more comfortable, I have my back foot lined up straight right here. But for beginners, what the book tells you to do, you have to have your back foot angled at 45 degrees. So you're basically pointing right at the catcher. And the object is so when you're in your swing, you're able to swing and be able to rotate your back foot like that. And when you're done, you can push it off like that. So the next thing I'm going to be talking about is how big or small your stretch is supposed to be. So when you're lined up in your batter's box, here, 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 like this, you're going to get into your stance right here, and your stride is supposed to be about the length of your foot. So I'm going to be striding right about here. When you stride is when the pitcher's set, he'll come through his motion, whatever it is. When he shows you his hip pocket, right around here, or if he just goes like that, you're gonna be like this, and you're gonna step. And when you step, you're gonna go about that far. So you have momentum going to the ball, right there. Beginners, you have the standard grip right here, like this. These knuckles, your middle knuckles, are lined up with other middle knuckles. So what I used to do, because I hadn't read the book and I didn't know that there are two different kinds of grips, I would do the choke grip like this, which is these knuckles are lined up with these knuckles, and it makes you go like this, and it makes you uppercut, which isn't really a good thing. So when you switch to the standard grip, you're able to get down on the ball like this, and it's solid contact. So, and another way, you have to make sure that you aren't gripping it in your palms like this, and so you're not just basically getting locked up and your wrist will get really tired. So you're gonna line it up in your fingers right here and you're gonna have the standard grip. The next thing is that you're supposed to have a proper box, as they call it, for your swim. So I know some people in the major leagues who start like this, and they'll load up like this, they start like this. But for beginners, what you're supposed to do, you're gonna have your bat right about here, your level right about there. And when you do your stride, which I showed earlier, you go like this, and you have your hands locked right here, and you can rotate around right there. So when you have your hands right above here, instead of having it down here, go uppercut. If you have them up around your, kind of wrapped around your head, you'll spin and you'll be off balance. And if you have them just way up here, you'll go like this. And you'll basically chop right down the ball. So you have it like this, good solid contact. You're in your stance, you have your hands right above here, right about ear level. So the load is basically for power. So when the pitch is coming in, basically the same thing as when you do your stride. When the pitcher shows you his hip pocket right there, you're supposed to come, so you're right here, you come back, you can either coil like this, like that, or you can just step and extend, and so the load will have back and you can explode on the ball. So the load will come back and you get extra power. You're in your stance and you take your swing. You don't stop just here. You go all the way through, have the bat behind your back, start running. So a full speed, follow through, is this. Pitch comes, you cough back, all the way through, start running. So what I'm gonna be talking about now is what your bat angle should be. So when you're lined up at the plate, whatever your stance is, you're gonna have the bat at about a 45 degree angle. So that would be just about like that. So when you're right here, the point of the 45 degree angle is that when you start to swing, you can swing right about parallel, maybe a little down, so you can get through the ball. And if you have your bat up just straight up like this, your swing will probably be like this, and it'll either chop completely down, or you'll basically just kind of chop at it like that. And if it's at an angle like this, it's just basically completely flat, you'll start here and you'll already be dropping your bat and you'll have an uppercut right there. This is called the fence drill, and you're gonna line up about your bat's length away. The point of this drill is to have players stay inside the ball and explode right there. So you're gonna be right here, and the point is not to have your bat hit the wall, but to come inside and hit it right there. So in fast motion, it would be like this. So I'm right there. The 1-2-3-4 drill. So this is supposed to help your timing with pitchers. So this drill would look like this. You're gonna start kind of with your weight just balanced right down the middle, and you're gonna rock forward, back. So it would look like this. So you're here, you're going 1-2-3-4, and on the fourth, you're gonna take your step and you're gonna swing. So in fast motion, like this, and somebody's gonna be tossing you hard baseballs or whiffles. So it's going to look like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, hit. So this next drill, you're going to be working on inside pitches, which are probably here, and outside pitches, which are here. So your coach is going to be behind the screen. He's going to say inside or outside, and he'll go, here it comes, and he'll throw to you. So this will be an inside one, and you'll turn on it, and you'll try to hit it that way. And then an outside would look like this. You stay back, and you hit it a little later, so you're kind of hitting it right here, that way. So the position that I use is you're gonna have your feet swivel around so they're pointing directly at the pitcher, and you're gonna have your hand slide up to about where the barrel and the handle kind of look like where it connects. So you're gonna go like that, and you're not gonna lunge at it, but you're not gonna retreat, you're just gonna kind of catch the ball. So another one is you're gonna be in your normal stance, and you're gonna actually take a step forward like this, and you're gonna just catch it, and you're still gonna catch it. And you're going to start running. The last one is where your feet are parallel right here, and you're just going to go like that, and you're going to start running. You're going to bunch it, catch it, drop your bat, and run. If your coach calls a hit and run, you have to swing at the next pitch no matter where it is. If it's in the dirt, if it's over your head, if it's all the way outside, if it's about to hit you. If it's going to hit you, you do want to turn and try to get on base, but you have to swing at the ball and make contact. So the hit and run, the batter will swing at anything no matter where it is. The runner has to try to steal second base, but it won't be a normal steal where you try to get a good jump, which means a good head start. You are going to try to steal when the pitcher is about to throw the ball a little bit later. So if the hitter does miss it, then you still have time to get back to the base. Do you want to be a better hitter? Then read the book You Could Teach Hitting by Dusty Baker. There is one specific drill in this book that I applied to my grip, and it really helped me to improve my game. Maybe you too can find some tips that could help you and yours. And remember, don't stop believing. I took the opportunity to do something that I had always wanted to do. I chose making an iMovie as my product. I chose to make a short video with some of the most important drills and suggestions. I learned the book after... Hello, my name is Jake Nordstrom, and I've done a book of... I'm 11 years old now, and over the summer, I went to his house with his son Darren and... Hello, my name is Jake Nordstrom, and I've done a book report on the book You Can Teach Hitting. I said book report. Hello, my name is Jake Nordstrom, and I've done a book. What the? Stop recording.
Okay, ready?
You're still recording. Stop recording. Stop recording.
Okay, just breathe.
You're recording.
Okay, breathe.
You're recording.